at the Santa Barbara Botanic Gardens. We'll be joined by Interim Director Andrew Wyatt and Vice President of Marketing and Government Relations Nancy Johnson. Let's start our spotlight. Well, thank you, Andrew, for having Nonprofit Spotlight here at the Santa Barbara Botanic Garden. And I would like for you to explain to our viewers the difference between a botanic garden and a nature preserve or a park.
You know, the difference really between a botanic garden and a park is that a botanic garden has roots in lots of different arenas of scientific research, focused education, and horticultural display. It's a combination of multiple different scientific and learning disciplines that go into creating what is a multi-use garden. It's not necessarily a garden for just recreational purposes, which would you would normally see as a park. And one of the things that our collections are focused for is the broad range of conservation of plant species. On the site here we have many of our founding displays are based on geographic habitat displays of California, and those are representatives from across the state of California and from the Forested Province.
Can you explain to me how this beautiful landscape happens? How does the garden become a garden?
Well, you know, everything you see here is purposeful. It's a landscape garden, basically the process we have, we're an accredited museum, so one of only 35 nationally, and what that means is we meet the highest criteria in our collections and programs management, and the way that we implement those programs means that we qualify for this for the honor of being included in on a national level as for the quality of our programs. So what we have here, the garden is split up into multiple areas, and we have horticultural displays, various function. We have taxonomic displays. We have a ceanothus section, a manzanita exhibit. We have a desert exhibit, and those things provide snapshots into the habitats that you would see in natural California. Although we do also horticulturally manage those, so we have for instance, our desert section is a representative of three of the state's deserts, and then we also put a little horticultural spin on that, so we can display the plants in an area that gives people a snapshot into what a desert is. The meadow here is a compilation of horticultural creation of plants that you would expect to see in a meadow of grasses and annuals, and we plant some 3,000 plants into the grounds every year to create what people see. The process that we have is all this stuff is documented, so when we collect things from the wild, it all gets documented into our computer databases, and we can track back individual specimens that we have in the grounds, and it allows us to manage our collections on the ground. So multiple levels go into what you're looking at here on the garden's grounds.
Well, thank you, Andrew, for talking with us today, and as you mentioned before, you have a wealth of knowledge when it comes to this garden, and we encourage our viewers to come down and talk to you and learn all about the Botanic Garden. And at this time, we're going to be talking with Nancy Johnson. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Nancy, for joining us. And I'm wondering if you could explain for our viewers, who I'm sure have heard a bit about it, why is the building project necessary here at the garden?
Well, it's a very good question. And Andrew already explained that we're a botanic garden and what that means. And as such, we have an educational and scientific component to our mission. We teach, we do research, we have collections that need protection, we have a quality, highly professional staff that needs quality workspace. And that's what this building project is about. It's about collecting protecting our valuable collections of library books, our herbarium specimens, having decent laboratories for our very well-qualified scientists, having excellent educational space for children and adults for the classes that we teach, and quality workspace for our entire staff. And we have not had any of those new buildings in so many years, we can hardly count at this point. And it's a modest project to provide those very things.
How old are some of the oldest buildings here at the Botanic Garden?
Well, some of the oldest buildings are almost as old as the garden.
Okay.
in the 80s. So those are the smaller buildings. The buildings that you see mostly were built in the 40s,
okay,
50s, and 60s. Our library is a great example. It's an excellent library for botany, horticulture, for the everyday gardener. It's one of the finest collections on the Central Coast of all of those kinds of books. Plus, we have a rare book collection. We have original Captain Cook diaries, original Origins of the Species. So these books are of great value, and they need to be preserved properly, and they also need to be accessible by the public, because we serve the public. That's what we do.
How might our viewers go about visiting the Botanic Garden?
Well, we're located at 1212 Mission Canyon Road. I think that's a familiar site for most people locally. If people are coming from other areas, the best thing to do would be to go on our website, www.santabarbarabotanicgarden.org, and all of our visitor information is on there. Hours of operation, price, anything they need to know to get here, including a map.
Fantastic. Well, we've talked a lot about what the Botanic Garden has to offer to the community. How can the community, our viewers, help support the Botanic Gardens? What resources do you depend on from the community, and how can people get involved, possibly volunteering, donations?
That's a very good question. I thank you for asking. As this show indicates, we are a nonprofit, and so we do depend on contributions from the community. And we also depend on membership. This is a membership organization, and that goes a very long way to help support the garden. We have a garden shop here and a garden nursery where people can come and find wonderful things, unique gifts, and wonderful plants that they can't really find in a lot of other places. California natives, Mediterranean plants, and all those proceeds help support the garden. So those kinds of contributions are absolutely needed and necessary, and we've benefited greatly from the generosity of this community, and we really appreciate that. We always can use volunteers. There's wonderful ways to volunteer the garden, anywhere from pulling weeds, if you want to get, you know, get your hands in the dirt, come here. We've got a lot of work in that regard, especially after the fire. Along with some of the regrowth comes a lot of weeds as well. To being a docent or a master gardener, you know, a more highly trained position, if you will. We need office help, you know, just a myriad of things that people can do here. And they get to work outside. It's a beautiful environment. And we've had a great staff of volunteers, and we really appreciate them.
Well, thank you, Nancy, for sharing with us all of the great information about the Botanic Garden. And thank you to Andrew as well. We hope that our viewers will come down and visit and support this great gem here in Santa Barbara. You're watching Nonprofit Spotlight.
If you'd like your nonprofit featured in a future Nonprofit Spotlight, contact us at the information on your screen.